Hi,
welcome back to my channel. Happy Friday. So this is my cousin A5 size, but let's start with my A5 HON. It's also cousin size. This is called the Tiny Dragon, and I've really enjoyed using this as my writer's notebook. Had to think about it. I made my own pencil board using a Happy Planner insert when I bought the Mickey paper. So this is what I did for this week. We were trying to figure out what was going on with Bruce's sores, lumps. So Bruce is our English Bulldog. He is currently fighting cancer. And for a while now, we thought that we were able to get his cancer into clinical remission. That was our goal. And over the weekend, so I think Friday was when I noticed it, but Saturday is when I really noticed it, because then it started to grow. So he has a rare skin cancer, and that's why I don't really show him anymore. Without getting too disgusting, he loses fur, has lumps, they become open sores. So I'll stop it there. But since we started the treatment a couple weeks ago, the sores have been healing. They actually have healed, and the parts on his body where he lost the fur, the fur hasn't grown back. The oncologist doesn't think it's going to. So I've been looking at him every day and, you know, trying to see if it's come back. And again, she's pretty confident that it's back. And he started his chemo again. So today is the 23rd. We took him on Tuesday. We started his chemo, and the lumps that I noticed on him are starting to decrease in size, which is good. But he also got a visit. He also visited with his cardiologist. Bruce also has a grade 5 heart murmur. Knock on wood. It looks good. His heart looks the same as last year, which is good. So I kept this pretty simple. As you can see on Tuesday, I didn't do too much because I was really worried about the outcome of his visits with his oncologist and cardiologist. So on Wednesday, I try to get caught up with all the things that I needed to do and contacting like his normal vet to get her caught up with what's going on, just a whole bunch of things. And then here's Thursday, did a little bit, but mainly I kind of sat around watching him to make sure that the chemo pill that he took, you know, that he was just doing okay. And then tomorrow he has his, what I call his pedicure and manicure tomorrow. He's going to get his nails trimmed. So this is last week. And then the week before. And I should say, I should add, that the oncology and cardiology appointment was something that we made back in, I think it was July. Because they are a specialty vet, the appointments that you make with them, it's not instant. You know, you can't get it next week. You have to, unfortunately, it's a couple weeks out. And so his lumps showed up Friday, starting on Friday and then going into the weekend. So it kind of, I want to say, we kind of lucked out in the sense that it showed up the weekend before we had the appointment, if that makes sense. So I think that we really caught it at the start of the cancer trying to flare up. So in that sense, I feel really lucky, but at the same time, you know, it's back. So, okay, that's enough of that. I don't want, in case for people who don't want to hear about that. This is my traveler's notebook. I keep it in the back. This is my daily devotional, which I read every morning. And I also keep this in here. So this is something that I have beside me on my table as I'm writing or as I try to write. But let me just quickly go through the traveler's notebook. In here, I keep track of my weight and steps. So this is what it looks like. My weight is in a colored column and my steps are not. The little black stars are when I charge my little tracker. So I need to fill this out for yesterday's steps And then the wait for today. This is my weekly layout. So over here is where I keep track of my meals. I take an additional supplement, which I have to remind myself because there are strict instructions when I take this. So I have to remind myself when I need to take it. Here is where I keep track of my sleep. I started exercising again. So I decided to do it like this. So the supplement that I take gives me side effects. And so I have that in blue. And then the weights that I started to do, as of right now I'm doing arm weights, I put that in purple. And I kind of like how that is, how I did it as a bullet point. So I need to fill out what I ate yesterday. I did exercise yesterday too, so I need to fill that in and then fill the rest in as the week goes. This is what it looked like last week. The week before. And then this is where I was trying to keep track of my morning and night facial routine. And I fell off the wagon, so I don't think, well, I didn't stay with that. So I really like using this for my meals, you know, my sleep, my weight and steps. I don't know if I'm going to be using this in 2025. Now let's jump into my cousin. So this is where she's at now. Getting really chunky. When I started the cousin in January, I had no intent on doing this, but with Bruce being sick and then also my mom being sick, she fell in late October, if you're new here, I loaded it up with a lot of photos. But here is the weekly layouts or here, so you can see the thickness between where the photos and like magazine cuttings and things that I put is all right here. And then here are just the little stickers and washi tape, which I will show you now. So this is for this week. And if you can tell, I use the same washi tape that I used in here. So I need to go back and fill it in a little bit. This is for last week. And you can tell when you look at my spreads that I don't, it's a mix mash of different stickers, different washi tapes. Because I own a lot of random washi tapes. Like this is, I think I picked it from the Sanrio shop at the mall. This is from Happy Planner. These are ones that I made. I can't remember. Paper Shire. These are hers. And let's see. I don't know if the monthly layout still looks the same. I think if anything, I added Bruce's appointment in here. So that's there. And then I have next month set up already. Other than the washi tape, I haven't done that yet. But Bruce has his next chemo appointment on the 11th. Now let's go to the daily page. I think this is where I left off last week. This is my shark fin melon. So here's a picture of me and Bruce. So this is where I sort of did a little dump on Bruce's cancer. This is pictures of my mom with my nieces and their dog. They brought the dog to go visit my mom, so I cover them up. So here's more pictures of Bruce. This is Tuesday, so this is a picture of Bruce, which I thought was just really nice of him looking out the front door, enjoying the morning sun before we actually had the visits with his oncologist and cardiologist. More pictures of my mom. And she's currently living in a rehabilitation facility. And then Thursday. My channel has been Hobonichi 98% of the time. I do sometimes do the happy planner. What else do I use? The traveler's notebook. But Hobonichi, you know, they've been doing their daily preview, which I had been pretty excited about. Up until a couple of days ago, the discussion of their shipping had come up. If you're a regular subscriber, you'd know that I have been ordering a lot every year to hit the quote-unquote free ship. Because as my husband said, nothing is for free. So that's true. But I would always order enough to hit the free ship. But this year, their free shipping is $300. And I think it's just a lot for me. I don't know if I'm going to be ordering from Hobonichi for 2025. So I thought I would do a little shopping around and check out other journals, other planners that I could possibly use for next year. So one of them is Sterling Ink. The other company is Wonderland 222. Beth, thank you, Beth. She suggested the Stology 365. There's an A5, there's an A6. I thought about the Midori Hibino. I can't find the one that I purchased like a year or two ago, but there is that one as an A6. And then the Traveler's Notebook with their standard inserts. So today I'm probably going to break this down some more, try to figure out the cost, because now Hobonichi put out their full lineup, their preview lineup for 2025. Now I can try to price things out to see if I could hit the 300. The thing is that I have a lot of covers. A6 covers. I own quite a few. I own a couple of cousins, and my intent for this year, before I heard about the increase, was I was just going to probably buy like maybe one or two covers, an A6 and A5, and then my cousin, my A6, the HON, I would buy those, and then I think I would have hit the 250. But now that I have to spend 300, I just don't know. You know, with Bruce's illness, his treatments, you know, that we're still paying on, the damage that was done to my car and the repairs, it's just a lot, you know. And then the cost of living is just a little bit more than normal. I just really don't know if I'm going to be purchasing from Hobonichi. And yes, I could purchase from retailers here in the U.S. that carry Hobonichi, but the prices are also marked up, and I just need to justify it. Hobonichi has always been my big splurge for the year, which is why I generally don't feel guilty spending that much money on it. I don't buy clothes, makeup, jewelry, all that stuff. I don't do that. Here comes the helicopter. Hang on one second. Sorry about that. But Hobonichi is my big splurge of the year, and I just don't know if I can justify it this year. But anyways, so this is my thoughts of the planners that I could use for next year. So this weekend, I'm going to do a little more homework, but let me know what you are going to do. Are you going to buy Hobonichi? Do you buy from the U.S. retailers here, or do you order from Hobonichi Direct? Does the shipping cost, if you order from Hobonichi directly, does that bother you? Because, you know, the books are going to be heavy. So if I were to not hit that free ship and pay for shipping, and I look at that $30, $50 ship charge, in my mind, I'm thinking, well, for that $30 or $50, if I spend that money and buy something else, I can hit that free ship. Again, my thinking is really weird, but that's how I'm looking at it, which may not be the right way to look at it. Regardless, if you guys liked the video, give it a thumbs up. If you didn't, give it a thumbs down. Subscribe if you'd like to see After the Pin videos. As of right now, they are of my Hobonichi. And if you have thoughts to share about the Hobonichi release, what your plans are for next year, you can leave them down below and I will comment. I hope you guys have a great weekend. Bruce says hi, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.